Let's have a closer look at this SnowPro Advanced Architect certification. Like any advanced certification, it has the exam has 65 questions that you have to complete in about 2 hours. This will cost you $375, and the passing score is around 75%. It's valid for 2 years, after which you'll have to recertify. And definitely from the study guide, these are the specific domains. We have accounts and security. We have Snowflake architecture, data engineering, and performance optimization. Well, this is what you get. Yeah, this is my certificate or the diploma. I passed it, as you see here, in 2021. I passed it, with just 76%, with a free voucher from working from for a Snowflake partner at that time. And what can I say? All these advanced exams were new at that time. So I was working full time. I think I prepared for this just in the spare time, in the weekend, for a few days. And I felt ready to pass it, but not with 100%, 90%. And look, because we're talking about this, it is your choice, to share the score with anyone else, because the score doesn't appear on anything else on your certification. Nobody will ask you about this. You receive by email, something saying, okay, you can go online and find your score. Whether it's high or low, for me, it's important to share it with you, because this may encourage you to go for it, to try this certification, even if you're not super prepared. For me, at that moment, all these exams were pretty new. We didn't have even practice tests, to exercise. We had no idea what kind of exam questions we'll get. And I was working full time there. I prepared, I think, during two different weekends. And I just went for it. Okay, so the exam is hard, as you may expect, with many long scenarios. Okay, you need to find real-life solutions. Knowledge is not enough. Just reading, just knowing about the features, about everything, is not enough. You have to think about how to fix this or that solution and so on. So I was saying no appropriate practice tests for me at that time. Everything was new. Going further, what's inside? Lots of data sharing, I would say. Roles and access rights. Yeah, but specifically data sharing. Snowpipe in detail. Automatic REST API, the low-level API, and the new streaming, SnowPipe streaming. Kafka connector specifically in detail. You'll have also Spark connector, but Kafka in particular, they are very interesting in streaming from Kafka. Clustering key data modeling, and now to interpret the clustering information, what you get back. But you'll have to figure out, given a specific query, let's say, given a specific table, what kind of clustering key you can define on a table to improve the query performance. There will be a lot of cross-region and cross-cloud replication. That's an advanced feature because, definitely to replicate the whole account, you need also a different edition. Just repeat the streams and tasks, specifically for CDC, for change data capture. There is a specific scenario where you create a task that will check specifically for a stream which is attached to a table if the table receives new data. And this task specifically should usually run a merge operation just to update a target table. Repeat this scenario, understand it properly, you'll be good to go then. Debugging and query performance optimization. So when I say debugging, there is not too much code here. You'll see later on in data engineering exam, you'll have plenty of code. But here, they are interested more in you finding solutions. And debugging is figuring out, issues, what's wrong with a query, with a data transfer, and so on. I mentioned before secure data sharing, and they will be asking you a lot of questions about data exchange. and Snowflake Marketplace, which are actually data shares with listings, yeah, private and public. Copy into, yeah. Any exam we look into copy into because, yeah, Snowflake, it's a data warehouse and people need to bring to ingest huge volumes of data into Snowflake, okay? But in this specific exam, they will be more interested into complex data recovery scenarios and so on. So look at those particular parameters, keys, clauses that deal with data validation, that deal with, okay, what to do if you have an error and so on. Okay, finally, I mentioned already about roles and privileges. So I insist once again on object privileges, on ownership. For specific scenarios for a Snowpipe, let's say, for a share and so on. So more complex scenarios.